So I really like student energy for a couple of reasons. First of all, it's engaging professionals right at the beginning of their careers. It's not saying, well, you know, sort of first learn the ropes, first learn how the energy sector works, first learn how architecture works, first learn how marketing works, and then we'll kind of bolt on. It's actually saying this is a core part of how every problem gets solved, and it's getting students at exactly the kind of right point of their career, so they just sort of won't know any other way to problem solve other than a way that is consistent with a climate and resource constrained world. The second thing I really like is the interdisciplinary approach, because these problems are wicked. They are hard problems. You can't solve the climate challenge or any of the other planetary boundary challenges, from biodiversity, phosphate, the whole thing. You can't solve any of them without taking a multidisciplinary approach. It's going to require anthropology and business and finance and engineering and deep science and so on. And so I think starting to build those networks and starting to build the awareness and the skills early that you can, of course you can go deep and solve that bit of the problem, but you're going to have to work with others to get it out there and implemented at a useful scale, incredibly important lesson.
I think that my favorite part was, I would say it was the moment that I met with every other chapter members at a leadership day. And because we've been talking for so long and so different ideas, so different perspectives, and it was really intense for me to meet all of them in person.
But my favorite part is like the networking session, because I can talk with somebody from, I don't know, Europe, Asia, Africa, America, from all around the world, so that's the best part for me.
I came in with no expectations at all and have found that there's this whole global community of people working on like every aspect of the energy transition. So I've met engineers, I've met finance people, I've met policy junkies, I've met some really incredible speakers who are doing work that I might want to do down the line. So just finding that there's this whole community of people like me that I never would have met in the US was just a really incredible experience.
The energy space, in our view, is going through a complete revolution. From a top-down system, it's going to develop into a bottom-up system. So we need new type of brains to think about how it's need to be. And that means usually it's sort of an interdisciplinary bunch of people that is needed. I think student energy has a really cool positioning, because it is trying to motivate students of different backgrounds for this big, big mission of going zero carbon in energy. And I think that's a really important activity to do.
There are definitely a set of skills and capabilities that we think young people are going to need for the future. They're going to need to be creative, they're going to need to be curious, they're going to need to be able to network, to work collaboratively. And I think that today's kind of leadership track and the work that you do as Student Energy really give the young people opportunities to learn all those skills.
It was incredible. I think the fact that I was given the opportunity to moderate a panel, HSBC's sustainability panel, was really speaking to Student Energy's ability to empower young people, to give me a chance to learn a lot more about finance and its role in fighting climate change and shifting forward the transition of our energy system. The other thing that I really liked about moderating was actually at the very end, when we did questions and answers, the ability to just pass it off to other students so that they could ask tough questions and really just hear the perspectives of other people in that conversation. It was incredible, and I'm really grateful for that opportunity.
So from a very kind of wide perspective, we've seen how student activism and the student voice is really powerful in helping shape change through regulators and policy makers. It's great to see so many really intelligent, really diverse, really forward-thinking and innovative young people come together. I think Student Energy provides that framework to unite those voices, start finding the solutions that we need for the future, and prepare young people to develop the skills needed to deliver. So skill development on one side, all of the other soft skills, like to be innovative, to be forward-thinking, to be tenacious, that was one of the key themes that came up today always ask questions, always challenge. The future has not been written yet, so you know, you can make that happen.